Android Studio version 4.0 is now available for download on the Stable channel. This new version of Android Studio adds new features: a new motion editor, build speed window, live layout inspector, multi-preview for your layouts, support for Kotlin DSL script files, and a smart editor for R8 rules. Android Studio 4.0 includes a visual design editor for the motion layout type, making it easier to create and preview animations. The motion editor provides a simple interface for manipulating elements from the motion layout library that serves as the foundation for animation in Android apps. In previous releases, creating and altering these elements required manually editing constraints in XML resource files. Now, the motion editor can generate this XML for you, with support for start and end states, keyframes, transitions, and timelines. We have updated the layout inspector to provide complete real-time insight into your app's UI. Along with many of the same features of the existing layout inspector, the live layout inspector also includes a dynamic layout hierarchy which updates as the views on the device change. Additionally, the property values resolution stack helps you to investigate where a resource property value originates in the source code and navigate to its location by following the hyperlink in the properties pane. Lastly, the 3D view assists you by showing your app's view hierarchy at runtime with advanced 3D visualization. To use this feature in the Live Layout Inspector window, simply click on the layout and rotate it. You can use the Live Layout Inspector only when deploying your app to device running API 29 or higher. You must also enable the feature by navigating to File, Settings, Experimental, and checking the box next to Enable Live Layout Inspector. Layout validation is a visual tool for previewing layouts in different devices and configurations at the same time, which can help catch potential issues in your layouts. You can access this feature by clicking on the Layout Validation tab in the top right corner of the IDE window. In the Layout Validation window, you can select from four different configuration sets, including Pixel devices, where you can preview your app on a selection of Pixel devices, Custom, where you can preview your app using custom display options, such as screen orientation or language, Colorblind, where you can preview your app using simulations of common types of color blindness, and font sizes, where you can preview your app using variety of font sizes. To switch between these configuration sets, select from the drop-down menu at the top of the layout validation window. Long build times are unpleasant for any developer, but it's hard to find out which part of your build script is making it slow. With Android Studio 4.0 and Android Gradle plugin 4.0, we're introducing the Build Analyzer. It helps you understand and diagnose issues with your build process, such as disabled optimizations and improperly configured tasks. You can also specify the default setting for these features across all modules in a project by including one or more of the following in your project's Gradle properties file. If you haven't already done so, install the version 4.0 of the Gradle plugin to make this work, and build your app by selecting Build Make Project from the menu bar. After that, select View Tool Windows Build from the menu bar. Finally, in the Build window, open the Build Analyzer window in one of the following ways. After Android Studio finishes building your project, click the Build Analyzer tab, or after Android Studio finishes building your project, click the link in the right side of the Build Output window. Based on your feedback, the CPU Profiler UI has been improved to provide a more intuitive workflow. CPU recordings are now separated from the main profiler timeline to allow for easier analysis. For easier side-by-side analysis, you can now view all thread activity in the thread activity timeline, including methods, functions, and events. Events are now uniquely colored for easier differentiation inside the system trace UI to enhance readability. Version 4.0 of the Android Gradle plugin allows you to enable or disable built features such as view binding and data binding. You can use the features block to enable only the features you want, so you can improve the scalability of large projects. You can set the options for each module in the module level build Gradle file as follows. Android Studio now includes Android Live templates for your Kotlin classes. For example, you can now type toast and press the tab key to quickly insert a toast. Same thing with a log. For a full list of available Live templates, navigate to Editor Live templates inside your settings. A new Android Fragment wizard and new Fragment templates are now available when you navigate to Find New Fragment Gallery or click New Create Destination in the Navigation Editor. Android Studio now provides smart editor features when you open R8 rules such as syntax highlighting, code completion, and error checking. The editor also integrates with your Android Studio project to provide full symbol completion for all classes, methods, fields, and also includes quick navigation and refactoring. Thanks to improvements in the D8 desugaring engine, Android Studio now includes support for a number of Java 8 language APIs without requiring a minimum API for your app. This means you can now include standard language APIs that were available only in recent Android releases, such as java.util.streams, in apps that support older versions of Android. The Android Gradle plugin now supports Kotlin DSL build script files. When used with Android Studio, certain IDE features, such as the project structure dialog and build script quick fixes, now also supports reading and writing to Kotlin build script files. The ability to separate annotation processing into a dedicated task has been removed. Instead, you should migrate to using incremental annotation processors to improve build performance. You can now remove this setting from your Gradle properties file, which no longer works. Check out our quick guide on how to use incremental annotation processors in the video description below. In previous version of the Android Gradle plugin, all dynamic feature modules could depend only on the app's base module. When using Android Gradle plugin 4.0, you can now include a feature module that depends on another feature module. Let's take an example. Imagine a video module that depends on a camera module, which depends on the base module. When downloading the video dynamic feature, the application will also download the camera module automatically for you. Here's how you can declare a module that depends on another in your build Gradle file. You specify inside your dependencies an implementation of the other module project. Additionally, you should enable the feature on feature dependency feature in Android Studio to support the feature when editing the run configuration, for example. And you do that by clicking Help, Edit Custom VM Options from the menu bar and including the following properties. Android Gradle plugin 4.0 fully removes the com.android.feature and com.android.instantapp plugins, which were deprecated since the previous release. Developers who have not yet migrated their Instant App to App Bundles must do so now in order to upgrade the Android Gradle plugin to the new version, which brings its own benefits and simplifies your app's modular design. When building your app using Android Gradle plugin 4.0 and higher, the plugin includes metadata that describes the dependencies that are compiled into your application. When uploading your application, the Play Console inspects this metadata to warn you about known issues with SDKs and dependencies your app uses, and it will provide actionable feedback to resolve those issues for you. If you'd rather not share this information, you can opt out by including the following code in your module's build Gradle file. Starting with Android Gradle plugin 4.0, you can now import C and C++ libraries from your app's AAR dependencies. Gradle will make these native libraries available to use with your external native build system, such as CMake or NDK Build. Note that Gradle only makes these libraries available to use in your build. You must still configure your build scripts to use them. To enable this feature, follow the configuration steps by checking the link provided in the description below. Enjoy Android Studio 4.0, and remember that we are listening to your feedback on our bug tracker. Check out early builds of Android Studio 4.1 on the Canary channel. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get notified and share the video with your friends and colleagues. See you soon!